Sorry, due to some technical issues, the class got interrupted. So I am continuing from the last point. So it leads to higher competition in the market because there are n numbers of manufacturers or n number of producers, and it requires higher promotional cost, higher advertisement cost for market penetration, because you have to advertise your product more so that you can educate your customer. So the example, this is one more point. It leads to high competition, one more point, and it requires high promotional activity. So these are all the features, salient features of mass marketing. Fine. So the best examples are all the fast moving consumer goods, FMCG, then the Surf Excel. I have taken Surf Excel, Colgate, Colgate Palmolive, Close-Up Toothpaste, and Sunsilk Shampoos, all the fast moving consumer goods you can take an example for mass marketing. Then the second type of market, second level of is segment market. Segment market we individually studied which are they, right? So segment market, you divide the entire market on the basis of demographic demographic features like age, gender, occasion, and geographical segmentation like northern part, southern part, eastern part, western part, etc. Then buying behavior of the customer. So these are all we have studied or we have discussed in detail. That is called segment market. Fine. So the better example is for a bus ticket to Bangalore. In any festival season, the cost of ticket will increase. Fine. In off season, the cost of ticket will be reduced. So these occasions and all buying behavior we have studied in behavioral segmentation. So all the individual segment comes under segment market. Segmentation is nothing but dividing the heterogeneous or entire large market into smaller unit and regrouping those units. This is called market segmentation. And the one more is niche marketing. We call it as niche marketing. So niche market targets and precisely fewer customer because their products are very unique. See, we have taken an example of Rado Wash, BMW cars, Harley Davidson bike. They cannot focus the entire market. Fine. There are only few people who can afford these things. There are only few people who can buy this product. There are only few people who are indebted. Excuse me. There are only few people who would like to use this product. So this few people only, you have to focus, you have to target only those few people. So niche marketing is very important for 2 marks as well as 5 marks. Individually they ask, what do you mean by niche marketing and what are its advantages for 5 marks. So niche marketing, it is a group of customers or business that all have a very specific needs or wants. See, even though 100 rupee watch also shows time, but this Rado watch, it costs lakhs together. A single piece of wrist watch costs lakhs together, Rado watch. Why consumer, why customer buy this thing, Rado watch? Because their needs, or they may buy this Rado watch for their status issue, because Rado watch is used as a status symbol. Fine. So Rado watch company never targets the mass market, huge market. They focus on certain class people, then so that those people have the buying capacity of this particular product. So niche marketing is a group of customers or business that all have a very specific need or want. So the market size, of course, market size will be very small. Market size is very small, and advantages, customers are specific and customers are precise, so that you can target them very easily. That your promotional activities, your advertisement cost, you have to promote your product to only those people who have the capacity to buy these unique things. So, if you focus only on those customers, unprofitable market can be avoided, and you are targeting only few people means, as a manufacturer, you can save your promotional activities money and time also, because you have avoided unprofitable market. Then competition is very less. Of course, there are few manufacturers who manufacture these niche marketing products. Then it improves product to enhance customer satisfaction. So always, since you have only few people as a customer, then you can improve your product significantly, frequently. Fine. So there are another two market levels of market segmentation is left over. That is local marketing and individual direct marketing. Fourth one of the niche marketing is called local marketing. Local marketing refers to is nothing but you have to, you as a producer, as a manufacturer, you use local raw materials available and you produce those goods or services which are very reliable, which are used widely in certain local place. So the seller, under local marketing, the seller only concentrate in the local market. The product also have local appeal, local utility and promotional activity, and manufacturing, producing or promotional activities are focused only on certain place, that too very local. That is called local marketing. Then after local marketing, the last one is individual direct marketing. Individual direct marketing, usually business to business marketing is considered as individual direct marketing, because there are certain things. Say for example, if we manufacture this duster, then we need this part, this molded fiber or plastic part required. So whoever manufactures this fiber part and whoever molds this fiber part into this shape, then this manufacturer of fiber and the seller or manufacturer of this duster are the buyers and sellers. So they focus only those direct individuals. That is why it is called business to business marketing. So in next class, we will discuss in detail about these two levels of segmentations. Thank you.